I'm really disappointed about the epidemic levels of litter around the school this week. It really is not good enough.
Boo!
Also,
need 100 waffles to my office.
Well, that's kind of weird.
Yeah, it's kind of non-rats, isn't it? Like 100 waffles, but I guess I wouldn't complain if that was me.
Yeah, I really didn't expect that.
Let's hope they just keep the waffles. I mean, it's quite a nice dewy ransom, isn't it?
Well, guys, I think we should check out some CCTV around school to see if there's any suspicious behaviour going on.
Thank you.
Come on, guys. Don't be shy. So. So, Dr. Valentine, who do you think is responsible?
Well, actually, I think it's diabolical, really. I mean, it's going to affect our Ofsted reports, outstanding in 31 categories. We are the best school in the world.
So, how about you, Ms. Pollock? What do you think?
Well, all I can say is it was not me. Patrolling the Barbarelli every day, fighting the short skirt crisis, how would I have the time?
Well, I have no idea, but I believe you have an alibi, so let's have a look.
Antarctica. The Earth's coldest continent. The one that is most hostile to life. It's 40 degrees below zero. Of all the millions of species of animals on Earth, only one can live here permanently. In the distant reaches of Outer Mongolia, one of the planet's great migrations is underway. Few people ever see this extraordinary annual event. Mongolian gazelle. 2 million are thought to live here, but no one really knows. Each dawn, Cape fur seals leave their colony to go fishing. To reach the open sea, they must cross a narrow strip of water. And that is patrolled by great whites.
Cut that shirt in. Roll that skirt down. I hope you're wearing a jacket under that coat.
Mr. Mitten, what's your opinion?
It's all about philosophy. We have to ask ourselves, why? Why was he taken?
Jesus, don't be Egypt's potatoes. Clearly, it was Mr. Water potatoes.
Mr. Water's got an alibi, let's check it out.
So business studies revision session number one. Quick question for you. How can us short people rule the world? Us short people do have an issue with height. Height is a challenge which we face, okay? We need some height reinforcement strategies. Stilts, high heels are traditionally stilts in disguise that short people have used for centuries down the line that can be a very successful strategy. The main advantage is that they can be quite sassy. So what I want you to do, you're going to think pair-share for 10 seconds. I mean, 10 seconds of whether or not you think that high heels are sassy. You're going to turn to the person next to you, ready, steady, go! You'll see down here, as an example, this is myself and Mr. O'Dowd when we went on Duke of Edinburgh. He does have his uses. I appreciate him. Well done, Mr. O'Dowd. We know businesses need to adapt and grow. I do tend not to grow. I do have some other weaknesses, which I'd like to tell you about. That is, My beard. My equipment. I think actually my equipment can sometimes go faulty fair play. Yes, okay, fair play. Yes. Right, new topic with the use of demonstration. Need three volunteers, please. Has anyone bought a ticket to the gun show that is going on at any point? Thank you very much. It's fun to stay at the YMCA.
So, Mr. Garvey, that kind of leaves you without an alibi. I mean, what do you have to say to yourself? Well, I was watching the sporting activities during Charity Week, and I saw that Mr. Fortune looked like a very sly and sleepy fella. So, being Mr. Medlin, I'm going to have to agree with Mr. Garvey here, but why? Why did he do it? Let's find out.
Cam Murray, aka Advanced Scotsman.
Miss Dizzy, maths, it's all about angles.
Jake Colton, striker, dare to Colton.
Mr. Sarsons, this competition is history.
He's not gonna stop going on about that.
See you next year.
Struggling here because I really don't think this investigation is going too well. I mean, do you really think it's worth our while trying to find Mr. Thompson?
Do you guys?
Is that an emphatic no? Is everyone just like saying no? No one wants him back.
No, you must want him back. Come on, guys. Do you think the teachers want him back?
No.
Crazy what I'm about to say. I think our game show hosts, Matt and Aaron, have a pretty good idea to give a big warm welcome to Are You Smarter Than Your Child? Morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Are You Smarter Than Your Child? I guess without further ado, could we welcome one of
our guests? Let's go, the Savinos, come on, the Savinos! It's Miss Savin and her daughter, Rose Savin, big hand, guys! Next up is the Beer Allens, Miss Beer Allen and her daughter, Yasmin! And finally, put your hands together for Mrs. Mayer and her son, Alan!
So, I think we're gonna kick it off. First up, quick question for the Savins. Let's start off.
Let's go with the Savins. Our very own Carol Vorderman here, Miss Savin. We're gonna kick you off with...
We're gonna go, what is one on one?
Two.
Oh, two.
Ooh.
Two for Miss Savin.
Who agrees with that? Who thinks that's a good answer?
Rhoda, it's gonna be hard for me to beat that. One on one.
One. 11.
Congratulations, unbelievable stuff. Congratulations, Rhoda. Well played, Miss Savin.
Next one, to the Beer Allens.
Go to the Beer Allens, love it.
Okay, Miss, we'll start you off with a nice, easy one as well. What is the capital of Africa?
Africa. Think about it, think really hard.
Really carefully.
It's a country.
No, it's not a country, Miss. Sorry. I'm going to go over to Yasmin. Yasmin, what is the capital of Africa?
Zimbabwe.
Unbelievable.
Sorry, Zimbabwe.
Very, very well played, Yasmin. Very well done.
Miss, you still look lovely. You still look lovely, Miss. So, Mayers, your first question. Miss, I can see you're looking forward to this one. What is the population of the United Kingdom?
62.2 million.
That's pretty good.
That's pretty good.
Okay. Whoa. No. Whoa. It's pretty close. Ads, can you do any better?
Any better? 64,299,321.
Fix it. That's a bit embarrassing. I left my answer sheet. Let me just.
No idea. I don't know.
Mayor. But it's tight. Oh, sorry, Miss.
Sorry, Miss.
It's just by chance.
Oh. Sorry about that. Look at that. Unbelievable.
You don't know how long she's been wanting to do that to me, so...
Right. We're actually going to let it a little bit physical now. We're students versus teachers, right? We're going to go for a who can mummify the person the best. So, Rhoda, you're going to be mummified for the students, and Mrs. Savin is going to be mummified for our... Not here. For our teachers.
Let's get on our teams. No cheating, don't start till we say go.
Around this way. Okay. 3, 2, 1, go.
Alright, it's a good start for the students, going straight to the head.
They went straight up top, first up.
Alright, Aaron, the teachers have gone for a different tactic over here. Full body coverage. Miss, working the lower ankles, that's good work, Miss May, keep that up.
Here we go, unbelievable stuff. Okay, they've gone for an all-in-one, the students.
Miss,
I know, we've had a breakage over here. Pixie, we've had a breakage. It's fine.
I'm not doing
this one. Are you doing okay? The students are off to an absolute flyer.
What are you going to say?
A scooch.
Not...
Miss, how do you feel being bandaged up?
Very warm.
Oh, it does look nice and toasty, I agree.
Toilet paper now.
They've lost control.
Oh, no. It's okay, she's going to come. This is fine.
Right. Good pace, miss. Good pace.
Here we go. And three, two, one.
Stop.
And stop there.
Mr. Cheating, stop.
Stop. Cheating. Well played. Thank you. Okay. Well, yes. Yeah, we're going to actually conclude it on that. So very well played to Mrs. Salmon, Mrs. Mayer, Mrs. Viran, and all of our judges. So thank you very much. Massive round of applause. Come on.
Well, from that, I think we all concluded that they're definitely not smart enough to pull something like this off.
But I think they must have had a pretty good getaway vehicle, don't you think, if they didn't have the brakes? So it's probably going to be some slick Maserati, Ferrari, like massive engine. So I think Pimp My Ride will let us know.
Tell me your blue skies fade to grey. Tell me your passion's gone. that your phone?
No.
Matt, obviously your phone. Hand over. Hello. Oh, Miss McConway. You're faking a smile with the coffee to go.
You tell me your life's been way off line. You fall to pieces every time. And I don't need no care at all. Cause you had a bad day. You take the one down. You sing a sad song just to try.
These are their new demands. They now want Mrs. Pullen's megaphone to Science 11. And I'm really worried, because this is the last person they took.
Not another ransom video. I don't know how we're going to meet these demands anymore. Anyway, I think it's time to welcome the Rugby Boys to do their performance. Take it away, boys!
Sort of situation, so I'm just trying to locate it.
Okay, well, thank you for your help anyway.
These are the kidnappers' final demands. They need Dr. Valentine's academic gown and hood taken to the conference room in the Barbaroli Hall.
Well, this is going well. I reckon we need to find someone who's brave. That's the one that stole Mr. Thompson. Someone that's silly enough to think they're going to get away with it.
Let's have a look.
Preston Lacey.
I'm Wee Man.
I'm Joe.
And I'm Dwayne Oxford. Welcome to Jackass.
This is the BB Gun Endurance. Go.
A little bit more, come on.
Let's make this a bit harder.
Hi, I'm Jake Christoforo, and this is a stinging nettle roller. Oh!
Look at me, Jake. No.
Season, it all comes to now.
Boys, big hits right from the off. I want 100% effort from you now.
We've got to do our hardest. We've got to put in a shift.
This is our turf.
I am so sweaty. Let's do this.
Who are we?
Blues.
What do we stand for?
Blues.
What's my favourite colour?
Blues.
They're definitely brave enough, but more clueless than Mr. Cummings playing dodgeball. To be doing this and thinking they can get away with it, it's nonsense, no chance, definitely wasn't them. Let's get some more help on this. We've already got the getaway vehicle covered, but we're still not sure who the kidnapper is. Really? Ninjas in Converse?
Do you guys know anything about Mr. Thompson?
Let's have a look then.
Mr. Thompson, how would you begin to describe Mr. Thompson?
Mr. Thompson is flawless.
He's the queen bee.
I hear his assembly cloak is insured for £10,000.
I hear he does e-safety commercials in Japan.
His favourite movie is Mean Girls.
He's basically teacher royalty.
The other two are just his little workers.
Okay, who here has been personally victimised by Mr. Thompson?
We have caught the kidnapper.
Ooh. Had a murder recount.
And this is his punishment.
Safety assembly. Okay, now we can get on to show you the Christmas year review that we really want to show you guys. Let's play it.
Talking to the friend within.
Thank you.
this year. It's been an absolute pleasure.
And thank you so much to Andrew and everyone that worked with him on the production. And to Annie, Eleanor and Libby for doing the videos, and to all those that helped put the review together.
A further thank you for all your fantastic support in the last couple of days. We're all really proud and excited over the last couple of days to what we raised. So a massive thank you for all of that.
Have a great Christmas, everyone. Thank you.